You make me feel so young. You make me feel so spring has sprung. And every time I see you grin, I'm such a happy individual. The moment that you speak, I wanna go.
Surprise!
Oh, hi. Oh, hi.
Great! Half an hour down there.
I'll never straighten my leg again, and for what? Oh, hi.
All right, we didn't surprise you at all, right?
Well, you know, a fella gets to be my age.
All right, 34 now. There's no fooling you.
Jaded old right. Bastard.
Oh, what am I thinking of? Well, sit yourself down. I'll get a blanket for your legs.
Here. Now, I said no presents.
Well, if you insist.
Ah, give me it.
Where did you get this wrapping paper? This is safe. Oh, Axel, a bottle of whiskey. Practically full.
It's completely full. You son of a bitch, practically full.
So why'd you guys come up so early?
I got a shower. And Walgreens coming
up. I've got an assignment tonight.
Oh, yeah?
Couldn't get out of the,
What's playing tonight?
At Theater Now, the world's premiere of Drums Along the Wabash.
Catchy title.
I'm looking forward to it.
I'll watch for your review.
You want to read it now?
Here's your card.
Oh, thanks.
We figured you'd be tired, so we came up early to get things started. Straighten up a little, make a salad.
Inflate whooping cushions.
All the niceties, right.
That's right.
Talking out to Will Cubbert, Terre Haute, Indiana's most promising young middle-aged architect. Tell us, Willum, what's your favorite sexual position?
Third from the top, I guess.
Uh-huh.
Did you read your card?
What's all this?
Three bean salad.
Oh, well, Tansy, you're gonna have to...
I figured we could eat in here by the fireplace, and if it gets too crowded, we could spill out onto the porch.
Did you do any of this?
Me? Prepare food? Right, babe. You mean my food to spill onto the porch. Well, spill on the carpet.
Happy birthday, five-year-old. Pretty cruel, Tansy.
Keep reading!
Now that you are eight, all right, I get it. 4, 6, 3, 2, okay.
I couldn't find one that said 34, so I got 6 that added
that
up.
That added up, sure. Gosh, I'm 6 little kids.
Christ, Tansy. You think you made enough macaroni salad?
Hey, button it, meathead.
Now I know why there's a nationwide macaroni shortage. Terrible thing. I passed 2 little Bronner Scouts outside crying their eyes out because they had nothing to make their necklaces out of.
Aw, Tansy. Tansy, this is really nice.
Isn't that a nice little poem? I came across it and it made me think of you.
Oh, me. Come here. Thank you, sweetie.
Perfectly all right.
Oh. Hell.
Well, I guess you cheered him up.
All right, I'm doing my best, okay?
So what have we here then?
Never mind.
One little endearment's made it that much tougher on him when you're gone.
That wasn't my intention.
Come on. Not doing my favors with that kind of stuff. I'm gonna hate watching a perfectly good landlord walking around with his gut scrambled because some little brown-eyed patootie tossed him an extra couple of macaroons before she hit the road.
Axel.
He used to be a pretty good lapper. I don't know if you remember.
It's his birthday.
So give him a tie. Or give him what he really wants. The guy's 34, for God's sake. He needs someone to look after him in his dotage.
Not me.
Come on. Does Washington really need one more weather girl?
Axel. I am leaving here 1 week from tomorrow, and nothing, but nothing! All right, I know how I must look to you, like some parody of the New Woman, casting off her chains to go be the Washington weather girl.
I didn't say that. You put it awfully well, but I didn't say that.
And all right, so maybe it's not the loftiest goal ever pursued by womankind or anything. But to me, it just happens to be that damn thing. The one chance that comes along in your life that you just gotta grab. Because if you don't, then before you know it, your eyes glaze over. And whatever or whoever you gave it up for, you start to resent. And I'm not gonna do that, Willum.
Well, some favor you're doing him. Willum, there's something bigger than us. A wonderful something called meteorology.
Willum will be all right.
I think so.
He's told me so.
What does he know? Does he know you come up every day and untangle this place?
He's just been busy with his hotel. He needed someone to help
him out. So when you're yawning, won't still need someone?
Oh, so I should give up my career to shelve a man's books?
All right, so he's kind of sloppy. I mean, if that's what you don't like about
There's nothing that I don't like. Willum is wonderful. He's the sweetest man I've ever known. He's talented. He could use a little gumption, I think, but
that's gumption? You said that before. What is that? What's gumption?
Just something that people have.
I don't think so. Not anymore. I think they found the cure. It's like the Raja. Who is the last person you ever heard of having gumption? Lucille Ball, right?
All right.
So, what, Willum can't be perfect for you without having gumption?
No, please. Let him be imperfect. Somebody perfect right now would really louse things up. Willum's got his hotel, and I've got my weather girl. So that's that. Besides, here I am fresh out of one relationship.
Fresh? It's been 2 years, Tansy. That what you call fresh?
Well,
I'll never send you out for seafood.
Fresh enough. Fresh in memory.
All right, so you once came close to marrying a bastard.
Interesting bastard, I'll tell you that.
Interesting to the vice squad, maybe.
He was gifted. He could make people laugh.
Too many appetites, that was his trouble. Cravings for things, evil things, booze, dope, people in show business, candy, stripers.
Oh, I could have put up with all that, I think. That hunger. That wasn't really the problem.
I never liked the man.
That, I think, was the problem. If you didn't like him, there wasn't much hope for me, now was there?
Burn, you goddamn trees, so burn!
But I'll tell you something. He may not deserve it, and I know he doesn't want it, but I'd like him to know that he will be missed too.
Jack! Pardon me, honey. Jack! Jack Daniels! Where the hell have you been, babe? Have you had anything to eat? I'll try some of my stomach lining. He was a stranger. But I took him in.
You're a hard man, Axel Hammond.
Really? Am I good to find?
You remember something I asked you the other night at the Halloween party?
The Halloween? Was that you?
I asked
you. You looked just like Petunia Pig.
I asked you if you'd ever done an anonymous favor for anybody. You remember that?
Sure do. It cut me to the quick, too.
Do you remember what
made me feel like the Marquis de Sade or Scrooge or,
you said,
or Nixon
you
or
said somebody? An anonymous favor? Well, what would be in it for me?
Sure. So what?
I guess all I'm saying is, creep, that maybe I feel better about leaving here. Just once, I saw you go crazy and do something for somebody.
Not me. Not this bloke. A villain I'll be and a villain I'll stay.
You're not either a villain. You're a little self-destructive. Possibly a little pretentious, but...
Pretentious?
Well, yes.
Pretentious? Moi?
Where did I see that one? Reader's Digest, right?
My God, it's frightening. How could I have even thought of taking after the woman who knew all my sources? It was just because you were in the next apartment, I think. You were the only advice within walking distance.
Can I check my messages? I didn't check my messages.
Hello, hello. This is Willum Cubbert, November 4th. Hope you had a happy Halloween. We're having a birthday sort of thing here tonight after supper, so drop by if you can. No presents, please. Well, I'll be out most of the day, busy at work, Regency stuff. Anyway, I should be back by 6. If you beat me here, come on in. The door's always open. If you want to leave a message, wait till you hear the tone, okay?